Hi, in this episode I present the most common mistakes made by developers of Node.js modules. If you are a beginner in JavaScript programming and would like to learn what mistakes you should avoid, this episode is for you. Most of the material is based on public data from the HackerOne website. It's a platform for security researchers, which they use to report vulnerabilities detected in the various programs that are presented there. Some of them are hidden, some require special invitations, some are public and everyone, even you, can submit a report without much trouble. One of such publicly available programs is one called Node.js Ecosystem. Its purpose is to monitor the security of modules that can be downloaded using NPM. This program has been around for almost a year, and at that time, more than 100 different vulnerabilities were reported. The whole procedure looks something like this. We send our report with a complete description of what we have found and the steps to reproduce the error. After positive verification, the person who created the code is notified. When the error is fixed, it is verified and then information about the entire process is published. If the code cannot be fixed for 45 days because, for example, the person supervising the module does not respond or cannot find contact information, the report is published automatically. During the preparation for this production, I looked at most of the errors reported in this program and sorted them more or less by count of occurrences. Let's go to the video. A combination of the functionality to read files from the disk, that is, read file, and the parameter given by the user sounds like a perfect recipe for the most popular mistake in the series. The point is that the attacker can read any file from our hard disk. This error is so popular because many developers try to create their own support of web server functionality. The first example. We see here that the URL parameter from the user is combined with the public string and then passed to the function that reads file from the hard disk. The creator of this module most probably wanted the user to download files only from the public directory, in which he probably included all the data needed by the application. However, the solution he uses is vulnerable. Nothing prevents the attacker from providing the value ..slash or ..backslash, which means move up one directory. This gives the ability to read any file from our computer. The creator does not check if the file that the user wants to obtain is located inside the public directory. The most common method to test this kind of error is to send a sequence of ..slash that ends with a string etc/passwd. In Linux, it is a file containing information about local users' accounts. It is used as a test because it contains potentially private data and it can be found in all Linux distributions. We already know what string is dangerous. Maybe it is worth removing it from the data provided by user. This way, the string passed to the function that reads files will be safe because it will not contain references to the parent directories. And this is the defense method chosen by the next module's developer. It replaced every ..slash or ..backslash with an empty string. What could go wrong? We must remember that the replace function works only once, at the given input data. Why is it so important? Let's investigate the sequence provided by the attacker. It starts with a slash, then three dots, slash and a dot. At first glance, this is an incorrect path. So let's call the replace function on the first part of this string. So we delete the first occurrences of ..slash. As we can see now, the last dot of the three dots between the first slash and the dot between the second slash are the correct path to the directory above, ..slash. When we call the replace function on the remaining string, we will see that it generated the correct malicious path. To make such approach correct and safe, the replace function would have to be called recursively, until it would not exchange a single character. Otherwise, it is possible to bypass it, and it is shown in the code above. In the next example, we can see that the author is aware of the existence of a double dot trick. In his code, he checks whether such string exists in the data provided by the user. If so, it does not process it further and terminates the function prematurely. Under Linux, this code will be safe. However, we must remember that Node.js can also run on Windows. And there, the directories are separated with backslash, not slash. The code is therefore only half correct. Windows is still in danger. Only the payload used by the attacker will be different, because this operating system does not have the file etc passwd. On the second place, there is a user-controlled sequence passed directly to the functions executing some system command. For example, exec. In this first example, we can see that double quotes are appended to the user-specified arg parameter and then linked to the git commit command. In theory, this function was to be used to commit files with a message specified by a user. The problem is that the message provided by the user can contain an additional quotation mark. Please note that the function does not check if such one is already contained within this parameter. So if the user provides the character, the string will be terminated too early. Now, all you need to do is make use of the features of the console. For example, the fact that you can separate the commands with a semicolon. We just made it possible to execute any command by the user. Yes, first command executed will be git commit, but for the attacker, it's irrelevant if it ends correctly or what the result is. The matters is only if his command is going to be executed. Another slide presents a similar error. This time, the data is passed to the exec function. However, previously, they are combined with the PDF info string and already known quotes. The attack is therefore identical to the previous one. The last vulnerable module from this series. This time used to retrieve the computer's MAC address. Works regardless of the platform on which it is running. Please note its popularity. Almost 1 million downloads in the last week. The error, almost identical to the previous one, occurs in several places in this module, because each operating system has its own implementation. How would the correct patching of this vulnerability look like? In the revised version, parameters are passed to the exec function as an array, hence the square bracket after the word cut. The user can still enter any string. However, this time, the exec function does not allow any additional commands to be executed except for cut, and will treat this string as a parameter. A small and simple change that makes the code much safer. The whole hitch lies in the fact that many programmers do not realize that they can pass an array of parameters here, instead of a string containing commands and their parameters. On the third place, the vulnerability associated with regular expressions. Currently, it is popular to use regular expressions in such simple operations like checking if the string provided by the user contains only numbers. However, regular expressions are quite complicated. First of all, it's very easy to forget that the dot matches any character. If we want to check if the text contains a dot, we must escape it with a backslash. However, the problem that I want to draw your attention to is the redos attack. It is based on the fact that processing of some regular expressions in combination with properly crafted strings takes overly big amount of time. It can therefore lead to DDoS attack on a remote server. In such case, a user sending a dozen character request is able to stop the server for a few seconds. Imagine then, what if there will be a dozen of such attackers and each would be constantly sending such a crafted string? This way, our server would have a problem to handle requests from our customers correctly. So, what expressions can be dangerous? For example, such one, checking whether the string contains only numbers and whether it ends with hash. The solution to this problem is quite simple. Every expression that we want to use in our application is worth checking using the SafeRegex module. In a simple and quick way, it will let us know whether the string we use is safe or we should modify it. There are many examples of modules that have fallen victim to this attack. We will now take a look at a few of them. As you can see, some expressions are simple, others more complicated. The fourth error is an ordinary XSS attack. In other words, the possibility of executing unauthorized JavaScript code in the user browser. This error usually occurs when we try to display the HTML code together with the parameters coming from the user without their previously verification and sanitization. For example, as in this piece of code, when the href link is displayed along with the data coming from the visitor. Please note that there are several places where it is possible to execute the JavaScript code. First of all, it can be done via the href tag. The addresses do not have to start with HTTP or HTTPS. They can start with JavaScript, and then the code to be executed on a given page. It is also possible to add malicious code outside the href tag. It's enough that the val parameter opens the script tag and executes the interesting JavaScript code in it. There is no check if the string from the user contains the greater than or less than sign that is used to open new tags in HTML. The solution to this problem is to use external functions, which will prepare data in a way that is safe in a given context. One of such solutions is the escape HTML package. Some developers try to invent a wheel and create such functions from scratch. However, it does not always end well. We must remember that in JavaScript the context of usage matters. A sanitizing function that processes the parameters passed to the link should work differently than a function that supports only some attributes. A programmer who does not have experience with security can easily get lost in it. Sometimes the solution may also be to create an HTML tag and paste data to it as a text. And that's all I wanted to show in this episode. If you like such videos and would like to see more of these kind of errors in the other programming languages, leave a thumb up and a comment. See you in the next episode. Bye!